In Iran, also the same. Iranian, we have three groups of filmmakers, put it this way. The group that makes ordinary commercial films. The second group is propaganda filmmakers. And the third group, which is about 5% of filmmakers, are, or to 10, 5 to 10, they are independent. They do follow their own convictions. And they fight with any kind of censorship. Men and women in film cannot touch. During the film, woman has to be, women has to be veiled or scarf. The hair should not be out of their scarf. And even it's very obscure when you see the woman alone at home or with the husband, still she's covered all over. And they would like to have cinema continuous regarding to your question. But you cannot touch or pass any red line anywhere. Control. And stop your film, censor your film, put your film in the cans. This is the reason the cinema industry in Iran is broken.
It's a propaganda tool. Also, one of the things that I have to add is that they love historical revisionism. They will change any reality into the truth that they want to produce it to be.
Panahi is coming from the poor family. And he started, he graduated in, I think, in 1988 from a school of television film school. He started to become assistant of various filmmakers, notably Kiarostami. He learned the crafts. He learned, he has good experiencing of harsh life when he grew up. And in 1995, he made his first feature film, The White Balloon, which script was Kiarostami's. And the film received Camera d'Or in Cannes Film Festival. Panahi is the only one among a group of 10, 20 independent great Iranian filmmakers around the world who received every major gold medal in every 8 film festivals. He is the first one who contributed parallel storytelling and multi-layer storyline in his films, number one. And stylistically, he's always focusing on social criticism.
You should know as little ways that he fights the regime, for example. One of the things that you'll notice is that most of the men in his films are clean-shaven and they wear neckties. That in our lingo is a confrontation with the regime. The fact is that in Iran, men are really not allowed to wear ties because the Iranian regime frowns upon it as a Western form of accessory dress.
In a way, you know, being able to just focus on what you have at hand gives new life to, you know, things that maybe you would have overlooked before. Everyone here eats breakfast, but, you know, he eats whatever the bread that he's eating, or, you know, people drink tea, but Iranians do a very, you know, specific way of making tea, which is, you know, very time-honored tradition. But I think that's the thing that we can all see in any story, and that we should, again, challenge where these stories are coming from and where they're being told, and to sort of seek out, you know, telling stories in these very specific places that people might not know about, but then always rooting it in our, you know, in these universal stories that I think, for me, it emphasizes and underlines our interconnectedness as people and, you know, in the world.
I think of myself as an artist and how, like, fortunate we are in America to be able to, you know, just really practice that and hone that and be, you know, honored for being able to do that, and to see that in another nation we can do that was really eye-opening, because it's the same art, it's the same passion.
قرار بود که آدم تعریف کنه که فیلم نمی‌ساخت.